history.
Danny Williams unleashes one of his strongest attacks yet on Stephen Harper.
A majority government for Stephen Harper would be one of the most negative political events in Canadian history. Now, while I'm on the topic of the federal government, allow me a few words on the federal election and the very, very dire consequences that could face us should Stephen Harper and his right-wing conservative reform party form a majority government in the coming weeks. First, let me remind all of you that Stephen Harper, as opposition leader, together with the conservative Newfoundland and Labrador MPs, voted against the federal government bill that gave us the $2 billion Atlantic Accord check. Harper and the local MPs, conservative MPs, voted against that when we came home with that check. Their quote was, "Trust us. We know what we're doing." They said that at the time. Thank goodness we didn't take them at the word back then, because we'd still be waiting for that check. On top of that, we now have the $10 billion broken promise on the removal of non-renewable resource revenue from the equalization formula. This promise was made in the last two elections in writing, in their campaign platform, and in subsequent letters. And let's face it, folks, regardless of our recent financial well-being, that $10 billion would have made a huge difference in the bottom line of our province. But now, all of a sudden, because we finally achieved some self-sufficiency, we should forget that promise. That's what the conservative candidates are saying. After all, God forbid Newfoundland and Labrador get what is rightfully theirs as partners in Canada. We put up with that attitude in this province for 55 years, and look where it's gotten us in the past. Absolutely nowhere, and that's going to change. Stephen Harper's own campaign literature, distributed in this province, proclaimed, "There is no greater fraud than a promise not kept." He used these words as he successfully attempted to woo voters from our province to not vote for the opposing party. Naively, we trusted him. He rewarded that trust with a broken promise. According to his own brochure, Stephen Harper is a fraud. I think you all know my views on this issue, and I firmly believe that Newfoundlanders and Labradorians at home and abroad still feel the cold, sharp sting of betrayal at the hands of our country's leader. Other commitments were also made by Stephen Harper that were not kept. We all know that these promises are sadly not worth the paper they were written on, or the bond of his word is meaningless. American actress Katharine Hepburn once said, quote, "To keep your character intact, you cannot stoop to filthy acts. It makes it easier to stoop the next time." I believe that those words hold a dire warning for all Canadians. If Harper is prepared to slash program spending when he has large surpluses and break his written word as the leader of a minority government, the future for Newfoundlanders and Labradorians, and indeed all Canadians, will be very bleak under a conservative majority. Do not let Stephen Harper turn your focus onto a green shift in his attempt to turn your focus away from a conservative blue shaft, because that's what will happen. His list of broken and unfulfilled promises portrays a lack of integrity in his character and shows us that he truly cannot be trusted. This is a federal government willing not only to break their own promises, but they go so far as to break their own laws and call an election even though they mandated fixed election dates. There is nothing Harper will not do in order to win a majority government. This, ladies and gentlemen, is a party who purportedly offered a terminally ill MP a life insurance policy to get his vote. How low can you go? This is a man who wants an election before losing by-elections in progress that would have been closed later this month. This is a man who wants an election before the economy declines any further due to his fiscal mismanagement. This is a man who wants an election before findings are released on various ethical breaches against his government. It is so critically important that the people of Newfoundland and Labrador let Stephen Harper know that his treatment, his attitude, his indifference to this province is not acceptable. When I met with him to offer him a compromise on the broken promise, he told me face to face that he does not need the people of this province to win an election. So let's let him know that we don't need him either.
Mm-hmm.